Good morning and welcome to worship this day. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and worship Him in it. And you come and lead us. No, it's Flo is going to come and lead us with yet another microphony.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Let us join in our call to worship, which is found in your bulletin. I say, you are my God.
I say, you are my God.
Oh. Okay, we can start again. I started the wrong spot.
Okay.
I am one, you are all. I trust in you, O Lord.
I say, you are my God.
My times are in your hand.
Deliver me from the hands of my enemies.
Let your face shine on your servant.
Save me through your steadfast
love. Let us join in singing, O Master, let me walk with thee, which is in your hymn book.
As we come to time of prayer this morning, I just lift immediate praise. Mike reminded me here how much a joy it is to play the organ here, donated a little while ago by Betty Furman, a Christian friend here who lives on campus, and thank Betty for that. And that reminds me of a week where we had several organs that moved around. Dorothy wanted a certain one in the community room, the restaurant there, and Annabelle wanted one, and we moved them around weeks before I retired, and we're blessed to move them, so there were five or six of them, traveled around different places. Are there other praises today as we gather? Mike has one.
I have.
Mike and Mike.
I have a couple here. I want to sing praise to the Lord. I praise the Lord for all of you guys. you folks, some of you who have returned after being gone for a while, just to let you know that I'm grateful.
It was Mike's birthday last Monday. And darn it, Mike gave me a gift on his birthday thereabouts. Watch meeting, and then Mike gave me another gift today. And Mike, I gotta catch up. other praises we lift. See a number? Yes. Two praises. I'll repeat what you say. If you want to just name two praises and God knows what they are, that's okay. Or if you want to tell us, that's okay too. Praises for Cindy, your friend, and then praises for we have a roof over our head, a home here. God provides. God provides. That's Faye. I'm trying to remember. That's Faye.
We had a wonderful widow's dinner, and appreciate everything they did. It was so nice.
For a wonderful widow's dinner, and got to see wonderful photographs on Facebook of folk that I remember from the meal. Other praises.
For the staff.
For the staff.
That work here.
Absolutely.
Nurses Week.
Nurses Week, is it? You gotta have friends. I think some folks saying that. God bless the nurses. I would pray that even though health agency declared COVID over, COVID's not quite over. World Health, WHO said it's over or it's concluded. But there's still almost 1,000 people a week that pass away from COVID-19. And we want to be mindful of that. If you have a concern, ask a nurse here. What should I be doing? Or if it's a booster or something. I know I've had two boosters, looking for a third. Never had too many, I don't think. Just see what Walgreens says. Other prayers or concerns we lift.
I have a concern.
Okay. Since I'm close.
Right. I have a concern. Concern is for someone very special whom I love a great deal, actually two people. And I am very worried about them, and I'm almost worried to tears. And I would like you guys to remember these two people in your prayers.
We will remember this two persons very close to you in our prayers. We will.
Thank you, sir.
We had another week as a country. Seems somebody was making a lot of noise with a gun, and the neighbors came over and said, "Hey, could you cut that out?" Middle of the night, and a mass shooting. And then yesterday, again, at a mall in Texas. Killed and three in critical condition in the hospital now to pray for. Let's pray. God, it is good to gather. Remind us where we are safe here and warm and well fed. That other brothers and sisters, others of your children, God, have less than we do. Some spend the night on the subway because they have no house. We are mindful of those in Springfield who are homeless. We give thanks and praise for your Holy Spirit gathering us and speaking to us in these days of Easter, and we pray for the persons that Mike mentions. We pray for Chaplain Rick upon the graduation of their daughter today from Ohio State, and also for Chaplain Rick in coming up in days where he celebrates a officiates at a wedding. Mindful too, and pray for Pastor Rick after the passing of Chaplain Rick's mother. Be with those who lead the Ohio Masonic Home, the nurses, the staff, life enrichment, housekeeping, those at the castle, engineering. These persons and their work, bless them. Be with Brent Hathaway at the passing of his spouse, Ron, recent days. Lord, we ask these things in your name for your sake, and we pray, Lord Jesus, as you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Time we have some special music.
By the way, this is a hymn or a piece which Bruce, Chaplain Bruce here, introduced me to, and I'm going to share this with all of you. It's called Gather Us In. In this place, no light is streaming now in the darkness, vanish the way. See in this face our fears and our dreaming, brought here to you in the light of this day. Gather us in, the lost and forsaken, gather us in, the blind and the lame. Us now, and we shall awaken, we shall rejoice at the sound of your name.
The gospel lesson today comes from the Gospel of Luke. It is the walk to Emmaus, Luke 24 at verse 13.
the same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him. He said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there these days?" He asked them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning. When they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb, found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them all the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village where they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, 'Stay with us, because it's almost evening, and the day is now nearly over.' So he went to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?' That same hour, they got up and returned to Jerusalem. They found the 11 and their companions gathered together, and they were saying, 'The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon.' Then they told what had happened on the road and how he had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Oh, the places we walk, and when we walk, the things that are on our minds. And thank God for, at times when we walk not alone, but we walk with another friend. And we're mindful, because of Easter Day, that he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. And there's joy and hope in that. This Easter day, we enter into this day toward evening, and two are going down the road feeling bad. I think it's a Hoyt Axton song. Going down the road feeling bad. today are having quite a conversation. If you've ever heard a couple coming back from chapel, heard a couple people going over to lunch, and you're the third person, the two are talking rather animated, and you wonder, what are they so happy about? What are they so sad about? And in the gospel, we have the privilege of overhearing through God's word to us, through the historian Luke, what's going on, and we wonder, because there is a threesome when Jesus joins the two going down the road feeling bad, as they're walking to Emmaus, a 7-mile walk, actually. Imagine walking 7 miles after knowing about the death of a friend. Hard to come home, hard to go on to where we're headed after a death. But we need to walk on. And God, the way we hear this and read it, we've heard this lesson through the years, we just wonder, God is somehow keeping the two from seeing Jesus with them. And after a while, Jesus gets a word in God-wise. A word in God-wise. He's been on the edge. Will they let him penetrate their pity party? Pity party is sometimes verbal, and sometimes it goes on for a while if you're upset about stuff. And if you're a third person who's wanted to enter such a conversation, if it's a sad conversation, or if it's a joyful one, you just wonder when and how to interject, to get a word in. Sometimes you get animated and you talk with your hands. But if there's two having a conversation, and one might say to you, if you're the third one, please leave us alone. That's what they didn't say to Jesus. But these two are going on and on about all these things that have happened. Holy Week, people waving branches from trees and shouting, save us, Hosanna. Next minute, people yelling, crucify him, crucify. Next moment, they're in, and I appreciate the one who gave the upper room scene in the rear of the chapel and over the community center. Next moment, they're at the table with him, with quite a meal to be had. Well, Jesus does get a word in. He says to these two, interjecting the question, what are you possibly talking about? He says, what are you talking about so intently and so deeply? The Lord's question leaves the two standing still. They just wonder, what in the world, where is he coming from? Out of left field with such a question. Today, as Jesus, are you the only stranger who doesn't know what's gone down lately, things that have happened in these days? Our Jesus' question in the middle of this moment is, what things? It's one of those rhetoricals. He sure knows what things are talking about. He was the central character who suffered and died a horrible death and rose again from the dead. What is his facial expression bordering on? Is he biting his lip, ready to reveal? Speak! Just burst out saying, it's me. But God, Jesus, has a better way for them, for us, to recognize him in the moment. And they accounted to Jesus, they give back to him everything about Jesus that's true. They named him the one who was crucified, Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in word and deed, who the chief priests and leaders handed find him, they were greeted by messengers who said, "He is not here." And then one of the women was greeted with Jesus himself, saying her name, Mary. Want to feel appropriate when one, when God speaks your name personally. And the women who recognized his resurrection went back to, it was a locked room, they went back and found the men in a locked room, and they burst in and they told the men that he had risen. Jesus, in this point in the story, the road to Emmaus is 7 miles journey. I think it's about milepost 6. I don't think there are any road shapes on it. But milepost 6 along the way, maybe getting close to where they are going to, the three of them are going to start to stop tonight. He said to them, and this is from the Message, Eugene Peterson's translation, in 24. He said to them, "So thick-headed and slow-hearted, why can't you simply believe all that the prophets said? Don't you see that these things had to happen, that the Messiah had to suffer and only then enter into his glory?" And Jesus started at the beginning, and we don't have time for what Jesus said to them, but Jesus spoke from the beginning of the book. The books of Moses went through all the prophets, pointing out everything in the scriptures that referred to him. Somehow he managed to do that before they arrived at Emmaus. Make a look. At this moment, in the eyes of the world, they might have parted company. In God's eyes, Jesus sees their need for them to see who they've been with along the road home. Jesus started to go ahead of them, was asked to stay with them. And there's I don't know all the ancient languages, the Greek here, but there's a word that says they about twisted his arm and said, you're certainly going to stay with us a little bit. As you've seen that, somebody twisting Jesus' arm verbally, to stay at the table with them. Get to the table, and Jesus doesn't give devotion, a sermon, or words. He takes the bread, blesses it, gives thanks, and gives it to them. He broke it and gave it to them, and their eyes were open. And then Jesus disappears from their sight. That's the part we need to ponder on.
Jesus has other places to be and go, and if you look at Luke's Gospel at verse 36, while they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Jesus was there with all of those back in Jerusalem. For when they recognized Jesus' presence with them, they just had to go and tell. That's the mission we are on when we enter. There should be signs on the door of the chapel that says enter. Because if you see a sign on the door that says enter when you go out the hall, you're entering the world from the sanctuary to tell another about Jesus. Jesus in your heart, the hope you have. Be ready to give an account of that hope. And go and tell. Just about here is a Keith Green. Go tell his disciples. Hear the bells ringing.
Right.
Go and tell. Go and tell. So may it be. Amen. Good to be among friends. next thing that we do after the message, you've already shared, Gavin, with us.
I did, yeah.
Let us.
I'm sitting here with all the rain.
Might put that in place. Another, what, couple of Sundays of Easter before Pentecost, the end of May. As we want to prepare now for Holy Communion, let's share these words from the bulletin and prayers. May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
It is right to give our thanks and praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, through the Holy Spirit, pour out your Spirit on these gifts of bread and juice. Make them be for us a way of sensing your presence with us. May you bless us to be a blessing in your name to others, now and always. In Jesus' name, in the name of the risen Christ, we pray. And all God's people said,
Amen. Amen.
Chaplain Rick and I visited. He wanted to make sure I knew how to open this. It can be done. I will come around and share a wafer on top and the juice. And if you want, you can go ahead. Once you have this in your hand, go ahead and have the wafer and the juice. And there will be a helper to come and collect after I go around. I'm going to set the microphone down. Thanks be to God for his inexpressible gift to us of his only Son. Amen. Our closing, our sending forth him, our entering, our hymn is, Here I Am, Lord, and there is a musical head fake at the beginning of each phrase, also known as a rest. And Michael hit the bass note here in San Francisco. We've done this before, so I'll quit talking.
Here we are.
Oh, yeah.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you and guide you in all things. May the Holy Spirit lead you, make your path straight. And may the Lord be pleased with the things that we say and think and do. And we pray that in the name of the risen Christ. Amen.
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 He's great.